Hello, you tubulites. Come on in. Make yourself comfortable. Do you want a drink? You got a snack or something? Yeah? Okay, good. Lately, I've been surfing around the YouTube universe, as it were, and I was watching Ableton Tips and Tricks. And before you question me on that, because I know that I've made a full-time conversion over to Bitwig, I was doing it because I was curious if there was any little workflow habits that Ableton users have adapted that you couldn't do inside Bitwig. And that's kind of besides the point. What I realized was there's all kinds of little tips and tricks that I use in Bitwig without thinking now. And also, you'll be interested to know that I'm not finding anything in Ableton that you can't do in Bitwig as far as workflow, okay? I know there's things like convert audio to MIDI that aren't yet implemented in Bitwig. And also, on that note, don't worry, that stuff is built into Bitwig. It's just a matter of the developers making it available to you, okay? Like those algorithms, all that stuff is inside here, and I'm confident that it's gonna show up inside of Bitwig in future versions. But that's, again, that's not the topic of this discussion. I just want to make sure that the things that I do, like the little tips and tricks that I find to be really handy, are something that you're aware of and that you know about, because, you know, you might be new to Bitwig and these things are going to save you a bunch of time. Okay, so that brings us to the six tips and tricks inside Bitwig Studio 2. Okay, so the first thing is fading, and fading's a fantastic tool. Let me expand this, and of course you can go like this, and you can make them that way, and then you can bend them, and you can change the type as well, and you can bend them, and that's pretty cool. No problem there. But did you know that you can just hit Command F as well? I don't mean if I click on this, I hit Command F and it automatically creates like a 4 millisecond fade in. And that's good if you're splicing audio together. You reduce the possibility of getting clicks and pops. And you should always do that if you're gonna consolidate audio clips together, which is the quick key Command J when you splice them all, right? Like if these are all like this. And say these weren't the same audio sample, right? I put these together. Well, definitely first I would highlight them all, hit Command F so that they have that really tiny 4 millisecond crossfade between them, and then I'd conjoin them like that, or consolidate them, sorry. But there's another way that you can do it. Let me just drag this out over here, okay? You can simply just highlight any amount of it and hit Command F, and it'll make a fade for you. Okay, and you don't even have to start here. You can be sloppy, because here there's the possibility of accidentally grabbing this, and that's not what you want, right? So you can start outside of the audio region, just anywhere, just grab it and slide it in, and you can be sloppy, hit Command F, and there's your fade. Now, if you do that and you make a selection, like this, and you go, oh, I've gone too far. Well, don't click and start again. Just grab this thing and slide it back, hit Command F, and you're good to go. So that also means if you had a whole bunch of tracks and you wanted to fade in the beginning of your song, of course you could take them all, you could group them, you could put a tool on here, and then you can automate that to fade in. You could do it a whole host of ways, but the way I find to be the best is to just take this and highlight a whole selection until you want them all to fade in, hit Command F, and now you've got complete independent control of when each instrument fades in and fades out, unless you want them all to come in at the same time, okay? Now, there you can control the slope of the line, but there's one interesting, just like always, there's one interesting thing that I found that I thought was strange. If I click on this and I select an S curve, of course, when I go on and make a fade by clicking here, it's an S-curve, right? And you can shape that S-curve however you like. But for some reason, still, when I just highlight a section, hit Command F, it's this. And I think it's called an equal gain curve. Equal gain or equal loudness? I can't remember. But for some reason, it keeps this standard curve, which I'm okay with. That's, in general, the kind of curve that I want if I'm going to fade in a track. But I just thought that was an interesting thing to know. Okay, all right, and then the other thing is, of course, if you have tracks that start like this, right, and they're all over the place, you can still grab them all, Command F, fade them in, and they'll all come up relative to each other and be at full volume at the same time. And I thought that was neat. No, you can't grab this and change it after the fact. So you have changing. This is just the selection. When it's grayed out, or I guess blued out like that, this, you're just moving the selection, but you're not changing these parameters. Okay, tip number two, warping two audio tracks together. So here we go. We have our Happy Indian Man sample again. And I've just double-clicked one and brought up the editor. And now you click the layered editing feature. Of course, you got to hit Command and select the other audio track. Okay, so... All right, let's put it into stretch mode. And so now you're doing the typical thing. You're just editing two pieces of audio on top of each other. But did you know, let's zoom all the way in here. Let's add a warp marker here. Let's add one there. And we'll put one guy there and one guy there. Okay, so now if I click this one, do you see how it goes a different color? It kind of grays out a little, it goes darker, okay? So I can hit Command and select another one, just like you would select multiple things inside your operating system or anything inside of Bitwig. And now those two are linked together. I can let go of Command and I can grab it, and those will stay together. So if I like how they sound on top of each other, if I have two microphones on the same acoustic guitar and I want to edit that audio and warp it, don't do it independently, because now you're going to create phase issues, right? You want to edit both of those microphones at the exact same time, and you can do that. What else is interesting is if you click one, hold Command, and then click a different one, same deal. Now those two are linked together, and I'm not sure why you would want to do that, but it's another option. And what's important to know is that you can just click one, hold Command, and then choose any number of these and select them all together in a batch, and you can edit them all together, okay? Super handy, and remember that. All right, so all you have to do really is do the typical layered editing thing that I call it, this stacked editing when it's in audio, by turning this on, right? Make sure you've selected both the audio tracks that you want to edit so that they're showing there, and you're in stretch mode. And then remember, you just click one, hold Command, click another one, and then they're all linked together. Okay, tip number three. Say you have gone and you've added in, you didn't use a MIDI drum kit, you went and you added in kick samples like this, okay, and they're all over your track. Say they're I don't know, say there's just like a bazillion of them, right? And maybe they're not all in the same pattern, and then later on you decide, I don't really like the sound of that kick. Well, there's a few ways you can go about it. You can do the audio replacer, the audio receiver, you can change it, you could gate it to trigger another piece of audio. There's another way that you can do it, and it's a little bit, I wouldn't say easier, it's just a different way that you can do it, okay? So this is called Nectar 1980, all right? I'm gonna come down here and click on Files, all right? Click on Files again, and this is gonna show you all the audio inside of your project, okay? And there might be a lot of files in here. Probably there will be a lot of files in here, but just type this Nectar 1980 into here to find it, and then you can click it and you can click replace, and it will conveniently bring you to the location of where that sound exists, and you can just swap out for another one, click open, and there you go. All of these have changed now to this kick. But what's interesting is the name doesn't change. And that was still a thing that happened in Ableton. If you wanted to hot swap, they call it, all of your audio, you could do it, but the name wouldn't change anywhere except for right inside here. Let's see if we double click. It doesn't change. But now the audio is different. Okay? All right, so that's just an interesting thing that you should know, because sometimes you just want to swap out audio, and it could be any audio. You just go here and click replace. All right? And while I'm at it, once you're done your project and you come in here, you should delete all the unused audio that's in there, because it's not being used, but it's taking up space on your project. So now if you want to collect everything and save it and send this project off to your buddy via Dropbox, you can cut down a lot of download time. If you've been dicking around inside this project for a while, you're gonna have a lot of unused audio, and you might as well just delete it out. Okay, tip number four, Let's zoom in here. Here's our happy Indian man again. I don't even know where this guy came from. He must have come with Bitwig. All right, so say for whatever reason inside my track, I want to shove another piece of audio in here, but I don't want to lose what's in there. I effectively want to bump this over. Well, I can take it, press Command E, and then move it like that. No problem. That works. There's an easier way though, okay? Highlight it, press Shift Command P. That's it. It's called inserting silence. So you can do that by highlighting, and then you can right click here, and there's insert silence, and you can see Shift Command P, or Command Shift P, whatever, will insert the silence there. But it's a super handy feature. And now what's happened is it's not deleting what's in there. It's just moving this over. Let me show you that again. Shift Command P, there we go. And now it's just taking this, bumped it over, and now you have some silence inside there. Okay, another interesting thing is if you highlight it and hit Command Delete, then it doesn't just delete audio. Like if I highlight and hit delete, see, now it just leaves this hole. What it did was, I'll do it again, highlight it, Command Delete, it deleted the audio and moved the rest of this track closer together. So it shuttled these two pieces together, and now you can highlight these two, hit Command F to create that little crossfade, and conjoin them, or consolidate them like that. Okay, so that's super handy. Again, that's how you can highlight, Shift Command P to insert silence, or you can highlight and Command Delete or backspace, and that will take out the silence. Okay, all right. Okay, tip number 5. Here I've got my loaded up drum machine right there. Okay, so say I open up the hat, and here's the multi-sampler, and I make some changes. I even just change the velocity, change the output, or something like that. Okay, and now I want all those changes to affect all of the different multi-samplers on here. Well, say I change the output to nothing. I can right click on that and copy value to all layers. And now if I go over to the other ones, they're all, well, see, that one's a different type. They're all at 0. Okay. All right. So in Ableton, that's called copy to siblings, but in Bitwig, it's just copy to all layers, which kind of makes more sense. And it's even telling you there's two others that it's going to copy this to. Okay. And lastly, we're back here in the drum sampler, and look what I've done here. Here I have an open hi-hat on the top, and on the bottom, a closed hi-hat. Well, in real life, is it viable that a drummer is going to be able to make both those sounds at the same time on the same hi-hat? Impossible, right? Because it's the same hi-hat. If he plays it open, he can't just play it closed while the open hi-hat is ringing out. That doesn't make any sense. What will happen is he'll open it, close it, hit it, and then open it again if that's the effect that he or she wants from the drum kit. Okay, so one thing that you can do is if you go down and you hear your two samples, well, this one I know is gonna cut out whenever this one plays, because that's just how it works. So what I can do is I can right click on it and click choked by the hat, okay, D1, which is this guy over here. All right, and so that means every time that this one hits, this one's not making sound. It's basically ducking that one, and that makes sense because that's what would really happen. Okay, so if you're looking to make realistic drums for whatever reason, or if you just want to use that as an interesting way to create effect in your drum kit, that's something that you should remember. And it works the other way too. You can choose a target. So if I wanted to select this track, I could choose a target and then choose the open selector. And now the same thing's happening where this one's choking to accommodate that one. Okay, it just gives you two ways. You can choose the target or you can choose what it's getting choked by. Okay, all right guys, I hope that did something for you. There's just a quick few tips and tricks. I know it's nothing fancy here. I'll definitely be thinking about this now. I'll try to keep an eye on what I'm doing that speeds up song making, and I'll compile them into maybe a weekly video of just a few quick tips and tricks. I don't want to make it too long and windy. I don't want to give you 2,000 tips inside one video, so we'll make it small and digestible, something you can watch in passing. Okay, alrighty, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, that's great. If you haven't, I would like for you to, but either way, you take care, have a nice day, all right, and we'll see you in the next video.